Yeah, this looks fine. We're looking for basically a signet or some sort of ramp spell. If I get Soul Ring, obviously that's the dream. Plan's not exactly to evoke Moldrifter, but that makes the hand more reasonable. Since if I just find a land later, that works. Do I keep Mountain? Mountain is all right. Doesn't cast Jace, so I could get a little bit greedy. I don't think I want Portal, because I have a lot of card draw already, and it's just expensive. So we can definitely bottom that. Mountain lets me cast Electrolyze, and if I draw an artifact, that's great. Otherwise, Electrolyze is good, or I can evoke Moldrifter if I don't have double blue by then. So I'm gonna bottom that and go ahead and top the Mountain, though I think it's a close decision. Because obviously getting to Signets and Ramp is better. If my opponent had played like an Island or a Swamp turn one, I might, and I was on the draw, I might not keep the Mountain there. Because this is really good versus green decks. Really just creature decks, but if someone's playing like Storm here or some sort of combo deck, then Electrolyze gets a lot worse. That's a little rude. Mountain gets a little bit better around Thoughtseize because our hand is redundant and that'll just buy us time. Thoughtseize is kind of tempo negative for both players in the sense that they're spending some mana and both of us are kind of just going on with our lives. Okay, so that was a good draw. Always gotta hide the best card on top of your deck, right? Which is what we did there to quote unquote play around Thoughtseize. Mesmeric Fiend. Okay, so they get my Electrolyze. Unless they just wanna slow me down. They could not take Electrolyze and force me to use it. That doesn't make a ton of sense. So I can just play Jace and minus, and then they can attack with Fiend, and then I can Cryptic Command the following turn. They have 3 mana. Looks like they really could be playing anything. I'm not sure exactly, but I think Jace just to cycle is fine. If they end up killing it with a burn spell or whatever, that's still 2 for 1. Ooh, that one's nice. Dax stealing a Mox Ruby is also pretty sweet. Then Dax does go to 1, but I guess in some sort of way that protects Jace. Okay. Well, I guess we could just Burning here. If I draw a land and just cast Burning. Depends if Hippie's gonna hit me though. Like, what if I plus Jace? Let's start with plus Jace. So I'm burning, then they're left with a Mox and 4 cards in hand. To my Jace and Pentad Prism on 0, so it doesn't do anything. But I get to keep drawing cards while they don't. It's kind of an interesting decision here. My other option is to Cryptic Command their team. I get another chance to just Burning next turn and keep Jace in play. But clearly they'll just attack first. This will attack Jace, this will attack me. And like, then what am I supposed to do? I have to cryptic bounce that and then play a land out anyways. Bounce draw. I guess bounce draw is fine, actually. Maybe they'll commit more to the board. I think I am just going to pass here. Obviously, if they play something first, I can counter tap. Maybe I should just tap drawn. Turn target permanent, draw a card. But this ties up their mana for the turn. Discard anticipate. Tezzeret can just kill Liliana, which is pretty nice. Pentad Prism combo with Burning here. So I could tick up Jace again, tick down Tezzeret, attack Liliana, have a 5/5. Discarded Hypnotic Spectre. That's also interesting. If we do that instead, I'd have to use my red source off Prism anyways. Maybe I should just draw first. So I think it's most likely I'm going to want to each player draw here. So if I draw a mountain, which I didn't, I have 6 mana here. I guess I'm just going to Tezzeret and play my land for the turn. Attack Liliana. And we're not really turboing this burning out, but I think that's okay. Like, I'm now ahead on board, I have 2 planeswalkers. Opponent's playing mostly a control deck, it seems. Or like a mid-range deck that interacts a lot. The anti-storm deck, really, is what our opponent is playing. Let's minus Jace first. See what we want to do this turn. And then we plus Tezzeret, because that'll inform our decision. Alright. So I can protect all my planeswalkers by just dacking the ruby. If I do... If I play this, and then I play DAC here. We're slightly less aggro. If they kill my Pentad Prism, they get to kill DAC, but obviously I'm not going to attack here. And this sets up really nicely for burning next turn. We have 8 mana. Liliana would be the perfect card. Luckily, we've already dealt with that. I wonder if that's a value Pestermite or playing like black red splash Pestermite twin. This is going to heal two of my planeswalkers, which is kind of brutal. The bright side is that this is still my plan, and I think if I have Pendant Prism and Jace in play, I'm obviously still massively ahead after that, even though I'll have two fewer walkers. And both of these already generated quite a bit of advantage. This made a 5-5 and drew me a card. This stole a ruby, so not really that bad. If they're killed, it's not like I've lost that much. Obviously, I'm just less ahead than I would be otherwise. Interesting not to draw three there. Maybe that means they have a red spell and they need to cast that instead. Like a bolt. Just take out all the planeswalkers at once. So they scryed top, but we're going to ruin their plans anyways right now. Attack with the prism. I think if they bolted, they would have bolted Jace, so I can pretty freely attack first and then second main phase of the burning. So play Signet. I don't want to draw them to an answer, so I'm going to Jace after. I'm going to Jace minus after. We're going to blow up Plains, Mountain, and two Islands. Card back and just keep the card advantage going. Play our land and say go. We have 8 damage of burn here. Okay, so our opponent's just about dead. Land, they die. And this, so I get draw step, Jace, and electrolyze. And they have to kill the Pentaprism right now, of course. They've already played the land for the turn, so they look pretty dead. They know I have this card. Okay, Mana Crypt is a good start to get out of this. Wow. This is kind of sick if they can... So they can zero... Okay, never mind. I was thinking maybe they could play a Signet float, like get mana and then kill this. That'd be really impressive. Oops. No, that's fine. I'll just, Tapping signets online is always incredibly awkward. Okay. The deck looks pretty sweet. FTK seemed okay. They had a lot of creatures. Duretti is kind of a value card in my deck. It's not super busted, so I can always make that swap. Crater's Claw seems okay. But I think the Electrolyze already kind of takes care of that. Oops. Let's see. Rift Bolt's another card I could play. Anything else bad? I think most of my cards are good. I like that Anticipate can help me find gas, because a lot of my deck is just mana. Like, I'm playing 17 lands with a ton of signets, but I really just want to hit my land drops because I have so many 4-drops that I have a lot more mana sources than normal, but a ton of card advantage, so that's sort of the way this plays out. And Anticipate's very good in that style of deck, because it just means it can help you find action when you're land heavy. Maybe I'll bring in the Crater's Claws for game 3 if I see a ton of things I need to kill. I mean, I saw a few that game. They had high value creatures. Well, we're never mulliganing this hand. Hopefully don't get Thoughtseized. It's interesting because against artifact destruction decks, you often want to slow roll your artifacts, like against green decks in Vintage Cube, but against black decks you just want to play your artifact mana as soon as possible. Like, I think this turn I just want to play Sol Ring on turn 1. It also, that lets me FTK on turn 2 anyways. But I also really don't want to get this Thoughtseized, because my hand is quite a bit worse. Like, this is one fewer mana. I'm just not really doing anything at that point. And my hand is redundant between Electrolyze and Flame Tongue for the most part. They protect one another. For example, if I get Mesmeric Fiended here, looks like it's going to be worse than that. Oh, Hypnotic Spectre. Okay. I want to lead on Flame Tongue Kavu rather than Electrolyze for two reasons. One, it just puts a better threat in play, but two, if they have Liliana, this will be stuck in my hand until I play another creature, and Electrolyze can finish killing Liliana after that. Let's see, do I want to play Academy? If I play Academy and then draw an artifact I want to cast, it can produce more mana. If I play Fumeral, so I think the answer is yes, unless they blow up my Sol Ring. Which could happen. So if I play this and then I play some sort of artifact next turn, if this produces two, then I'll have four mana. That doesn't actually really change that much. So maybe I should just play my island anyways. I can always play Academy for my land drop. Later on. Those are the kind of decisions you have to make when you know that you're going to sequence tap land soon, so you have to plan turns in advance with an unknown draw step. It's a little bit tricky. But this Academy having a downside of not tapping for any mana is interesting as well. If somehow my artifact gets blown up, smash to smithereens, that type of thing comes to mind. They can't dig yet. Alright, let's go ahead and attack. If they play Pestermite, I'm just going to have to kill it. I'll just do this. Say go. Interesting. So I have Flame Tongue again. Alright. I think I don't want to play Electrolyze simply because I'm a little afraid of them having twin value. Although, at the same time, they're almost dead. This just kills them if they have nothing. I can Electrolyze them down to 6 and then extend the hand. Zergo Helm Smasher now. Probably Mardu Man isn't doing something else here. Okay. Might just be doing it here. Cast this. Apparently playing a burn deck. Alright, so that's the bonus match. Thanks everyone for tuning in.